Hello, my name is Mads Peter Iversen. I am a Danish landscape photographer living in Aarhus. This is the fourth episode on my Photographing Iceland series, and this time we are going to Vík in the southern part of Iceland to a place called Reynisdranka. Reynisdranka is probably the most iconic cliffs of Iceland. They are located just south of Vík, which is a town located in the southern part of Iceland. They can be observed from both an eastern and western viewpoint. The eastern viewpoint is the beach of Vík, and you simply just continue on road 1 until you hit Vík and then drive to the beach and you can see them from there. You do get most bang for the buck on the western viewpoint. Just go for road 215, which is located around 5 kilometers from Vík in direction of Reykjavík. At road 215, there's a sign towards Reynisfjara, which is the black sand beach from where you can see Reynisdranka. At the western viewpoint, you can also see some huge basalt cliff formations and a cave. From the western side, there's access to a viewpoint which brings you as close to Reynisdranka as you can get from the land side. You do have to climb some rocks to get there, so make sure you're aware of the slippery stones. It's extremely important that you also are aware of both the tide and the waves. Waves here can get several meters tall, come out of nowhere and wash you away in the blink of an eye. The most dangerous part in regard to waves is the first, so if that's possible, you don't have to worry, you will have to go back later. If you do manage to get to the upfront viewpoint, you will be rewarded with the best look at these amazing cliffs. The eastern viewpoint is generally good for sunsets, while the western viewpoint is generally good for sunrises. The upfront viewpoint is turned south, so here you would benefit mostly from the winter sun. As close to midwinter you can come, the better. With an ultra-wide angle lens, you can catch both Reynisdranka and a good foreground, with the scattered rocks and seaweed. Also bring a telezoom to compress the foreground and background if you are at either the western or eastern location. Thanks so much for watching. On the next episode, we are going to Skogafoss. I hope you find these videos very informative, and if you do, I would highly appreciate if you would press the like button. If you want even more, you can subscribe to my channel.